My name's Andrew Liner, and I play Mason Ashford.
Hi, my name is Kieran Moore, and I play Dimitri Bellicom.
I'm Andre Day Kim, and I play Christian Rosera.
Vampire
Vampire
Academy.
Academy.
I'm John Harmon Cooper from Young Entertainment Mag. It's good to be with you guys today.
Hello,
Great to
thank you
be
for
with
having
you,
us,
John.
John.
Of course. I'm wondering, even though the show is new, you guys already have like a well-established fan base of the Vampire Academy franchise. Do you feel a certain responsibility to the fans, Andre?
Yeah, totally. I mean, we've gotten so much love and support from these fans that are like very global too. Like we have fans both in the States, UK, Canada, Brazil is huge as well. And I think we do feel responsible because we want them to really enjoy this show, you know? I know what it's like to be a fan of source material and have it go out there and you're really excited about it. And I think we do feel responsible, but we also feel like we have created something that they're
Yeah,
gonna
they
really like.
followed
Yeah, so we are excited for them to see it.
Very, very.
Motivated is motivated is a good word. It's a responsibility, but it just stems to motivation. I think it's something that is a love for the stories. It makes you want to drive to tell it, right?
Yeah.
And to love it as much as we love telling it.
Yeah.
What inspires you? What motivates you about this story, Kieran?
I think there's just elements of truth from every aspect. That there's people that believe,
Yeah.
people believing in different things, that people have been come from different upbringings, much like our modern world, you know, and it's this idea that we're unmasking that, we're unpicking it through the lens
Sure.
of a fantasy show. It's incredible. We get to push boundaries through a YA lens. It's great. For me, it's just that idea that there's so many different elements. There's love. There's the fight for love. There's a fight for fight. There's
Yeah.
politics. It's something that for me is just it's quite exciting. It's bold. It feels dangerous, and it feels there's something like leaping into that fear, you know.
For sure. And Kieran, I'm specifically interested with you since you're a poet, that requires a certain amount of emotional intelligence. And from what I've seen from the show, your character is almost like sort of stoic. Is it hard to turn that part of yourself off, or do you not see it that way? I'm curious.
I think for me, my interpretation was that my access to my vulnerability and through my poeticness, I guess, is that that made Dimitri's internal struggle all the more visible. It was this idea that there is a man under there. There is someone under there that might not necessarily fundamentally believe the beliefs that he's been led to believe, you know? And I think that was this idea of him unraveling. It could have been very easy to have Dimitri as just this physical imposing man
For
that they can
sure.
fight and do all these beautiful things. And but I think the excitement lies in his vulnerability. Like
Yeah.
Rose represents that vulnerability. She holds the mirror up to him to look at himself. And I hope my poetic background can kind of flourish in light of that. I didn't realize how similar or how useful that would be. It was actually the fans of the show, credit to them, that actually made that correlation. So I thank them to point me in the right
And I
direction.
think Dimitri is a poem in himself, though, you know?
Yeah, maybe. I like that. Go on, keep talking. Sorry, sorry, sorry.
Roses are
Very good.
red,
That's a
violets
good
are
line for the hat.
white.
Dimitri's here, and so
And
are
he's
you.
gonna punch you. Very cool. Andrew, your character, he's sort of like the cool guy at the academy. But I mean, maybe that type of role isn't necessarily new for you, but this world is very different than Grownish, which a lot of people will know you from. How was that transition from like very real life to very fantasy?
Yeah, you know, it's an interesting thing because I feel like as fantastical as this world is, it is very much rooted in reality, you know? And I think that with Grownish having the hard-hitting topics that it does have, and what I was blessed enough to go through with that with my storyline in Grownish, I think we tack a lot of hard-hitting issues here as well. With a fantastical lens to it, you know? So I think that, you know, as different as it is, it is
Yeah.
very much the same. And I think as an actor, I had to approach it like it was real, and I had to approach it genuinely and grounded as ground as I possibly could. So, yeah.
Very cool. Thanks, guys. Great meeting you, and congrats on a beautiful show.
No
Thank
problem.
you.
Thanks. Thank you for
Thank you
your
so
time. Yeah,
much.
thank you.
Take care.